Okay, let's talk about new Photoshop 2025. This update, it's all about refining the tools we already love and adding a few surprises that can help you work faster and maybe even spark some new ideas. Whatever you are, a 3D artist, an architect or a designer, Adobe just dropped an update that might make your workflow smoother. Now we can delete unwanted things like wires, cables and people. This is the perfect tool when you do a photo matching, for example, and you have unwanted wires in front of the place where the rendered building is supposed to be. Or when you use background footage and the cables distract too much attention or make the image look unattractive. Thanks to distraction removal, we can remove it automatically. Thanks to the fact that it's powered by the Adobe Firefly image model, AI can help with this task. It worked very well in this case. If we need to, we can very easily paint some parts back. We just need to have the original image copied. Let's see how it will manage this example. If you want, you can also turn off the AI. I removed the wires with all three methods. Here is how it looks with the auto mode. This is with AI on, and this with AI off. There is not so much difference in this case, but it's quite an easy example as it mostly has to replace cables with the sky. This example looks like a quite complex job, but with this tool, it's a piece of cake. It works very well. Here is how it works with people removal. You can see it selected them very well. It selected even the shadows and reflections. In case something is not as we wish, we can adjust the selection the same as we do with the quick masks. In this case, you can see that there are some issues like this person here. AI on works very well. At first glance, everything looks quite convincing. AI off is not bad, but it's the worst of all the tests. For example, in this area here, it doesn't look right. Similarly here, in the back. Thanks to the fact that we can generate with AI in the remove tool, we can use it to remove it more efficiently to remove certain parts of the image. Generative Fill uses the latest Adobe Firefly image model. Let's check how it works and with what options it will come out. Okay, I'm not really impressed with the outcome. We have super weird things going on here. Look at the faces and the shoes. Here, the faces are more natural, but still, this is not something I would use. Let's try again. Okay, it didn't turn out well. I expected something better, to be honest. Okay, but to be fair, people are very complicated to generate, have lots of details, and it's easy to get fake results. Let's try something easier. Perhaps frog by the river? Okay, it didn't handle this though. Look at this. It looks like a paint graphic. Maybe I try a smaller size. Okay, to be honest, I don't like these results. Perhaps they are a bit more detailed, but it doesn't produce anything realistic. Let's test another option. Now, after we use Generative Fill, and we like an option in particular, we can use Generate Similar. Thanks to that, it will generate results that match the original one. Let's test the last option here. I try to generate the green bed linen on the bed. Here we go. This is fine. Now we can click here to enhance the quality of the specific generation. You can see the output is more sharp and has more details. If we use the remove background option, we can generate the background now too. It may be handy for product visualization, if you want to enhance your background or completely change it with a couple of clicks. It didn't add the slices of orange, it made the background orange, but it added nice yellow flowers, which adds a nice touch to the background. I like the light here too. It adds more dynamism to the whole composition. I tried it with the 3D person too, just to see the results. Here is how it came up. This one is quite convincing. Perhaps it's not something we'll use in ARVIS as we focus on creating these backgrounds in 3D, but for product visualization or graphics, it might be a very handy tool. Except for that, we have new features available in the beta version. In the Creative Cloud, you can find all beta versions here. So let's try the same example as before. Now, in the Generative Fill, we are able to upload the reference image. I uploaded the man with the winter white jacket as a reference here. It's cool. It did a very similar style jacket and it added the bag as it was on the reference image. Next time I would probably remove the bag from the reference to get just a jacket, but still, it's easier to explain to the AI what we actually have in mind. I like it. The next tool is the Generative Workspace, which can be found under Edit tab. It is an image generation tool. So basically, we can type a prompt here. We can choose the ratio. With this tool, we can upload the composition and style reference. We can choose some effects if we want to. For realistic outputs though, we don't need any of that. We can also add some variables to generate multiple options at the same time for a quick comparison, for example, for color or material. Look at these images. I use the same prompt as in the ideogram to compare. In terms of the composition, the style, the atmosphere, it's very similar. However, in terms of the realism, it's not there yet. We have various issues here. And the general look, it's not super realistic. But the idea is great. I like to have all-in-one software, the workflow will be easier and smoother. Plus, if that will be a case, we wouldn't have to pay all extra subscriptions, just one for all 2D graphics work. By the way, we don't have to wait to create a new image. We can generate it right away. I try a simple prompt now, but I use images as a reference. I use it for the style. And this image for the composition. Let's see. Okay, in terms of the references, it did quite a good job. Again, it's not there yet, but on the other hand, it's just a beta version. At the end, the Substance 3D Viewer. It's an app that allows us to view and edit 3D content and editable smart objects in creative projects. The idea is that you can import a 3D file and work with it here. However, from my tests, if you really want to have control, it cannot be one object. In this case, you need to have each pillow, blanket, fabric and legs separately. So now, we can use this app to add colors and materials to 3D objects. We can apply various materials and change their mapping and characteristics. We can play around with this and when it's ready, export the file as a 2D image to Photoshop and work more on that. You can see it's without background, but it keeps the shadows. And now we can play around with the background. It will be a cool option for quick graphics. Additionally, we can import the background image here and adjust the position of our objects to match it. We can also control the lighting using brightness and rotation parameters. But look at this feature. We can generate a 3D model from the text. I type frog, for instance. Whoa, that's magic. It's not perfect, but I'm quite impressed with the result. Let's try something more complicated. A modern house. Okay. Not great, but we can use another option, 3D model to image. We have three options here. Let me go with the last one. We can choose some options here, like color and tone, lighting and composition. And here we go, four variations were generated. It looks way more convenient, isn't it? Now we can export it to Photoshop and work with that. That's impressive. It's not like creating visualizations, that's for sure. It's way simpler and you don't have as much control. But we have to agree that this is a very powerful tool to have with 2D graphics software. You can see that the new update is all about AI. All the improvements and new features are based on AI generations. Definitely, Photoshop doesn't want to stay behind and create software that can still beat competition. If you want to learn how to create visualizations and use Photoshop to enhance your images in post-production, join our training. You can also stay here on YouTube and watch more of my videos. Bye-bye!